I am Julia Maputa from Funda Wande, Limpopo province in South Africa. Funda Wande is a non-profit organization that works with the Department of Education. Our main aim is to help children to read with meaning and calculate with confidence by the age of 10 by 2030. So in my presentation, I'll be talking through the program that we used to help learners to read with meaning and calculate with confidence using teacher assistance in Limpopo province. In my presentation, I will be explaining to you all these topics in detail. What is the teacher assistance intervention program, Funda Wande Limpopo intervention design, the Funda Wande materials, the need for the TA intervention in Limpopo, how were TAs recruited, and lastly, how Funda Wande supports Limpopo Department of Education towards rollout and success of the intervention of TAs. So the teacher assistants, which in short we call TA, teacher assistant TA. The teacher assistant program was an intervention which used unemployed youth aged between 18 and 28 to serve schools in their communities. Secondly, TAs were not a replacement of teachers or second teachers. Their main task was to assist teachers with administration and classroom management. So the research design that we utilize in Limpopo during the TA intervention program was the randomized control trial, where we had a pool of 120 schools, which were split into three arms. Arm number one comprised of coaches plus resources, the books in the foundation phase, math books, literacy books, plus training of teachers and monitoring and support of teachers by the same coaches once per month. The second arm also had 40 schools, but then the difference is that in the second arm, we provided teacher assistance, we provided resources, the mathematics and literacy books, and then we trained the teachers as well as the teacher assistants. And lastly, we also monitored and support these TAs and teacher assistants. So that is the difference. The coaching arm, coaches. Teacher assistants arm, teacher assistants. And in every school that we were, the 40 schools that I've mentioned, in the foundation phase, each teacher was assigned a teacher assistant. Every teacher in the 40 schools, as long as they were in the foundation phase, they had a teacher assistant in their classroom. And then the last arm was the control, which was the business as usual. And then we conducted baseline assessment in 2021, midline in 2022, and endline in 2023. Let me show you some of the resources that we provided in both the coaching arm and the TA arm. In the coaching arm and TA arm, the grade R teachers received these resources that you see on the slides, a copy of a teacher's guide, as well as a box of manipulatives, mathematics manipulatives for the teacher and the learners, and a dictionary. I'm talking about teachers in the coaching arm and teachers in the TA arm. And then in the grade one classes, we provided four resources. The first one is called an anthology. Every learner was given a copy of this anthology with 16 leveled stories. And then the second book that was given to the learner was the learner activity book, where they read stories again, they completed written activities, they traced, they were coloring to develop their different skills of language. And then these were the copies given to the learners. Teachers were given teacher guides and big books. Another task of the teacher assistants was to ensure that these resources the anthologies and the LABs are fully utilized in the classes. I'm only sharing with you the resources for grade one. However, we also provided the LABs and the teacher guides in grade two classes, in grade three classes, and teacher assistants were helping learners to complete the various activities. And then these were the resources that were provided for mathematics in grade one. A teacher guide for the teacher, learner activity book, a dictionary, and a big box of manipulatives for both the teacher and the learners. So these were the resources provided for maths in grade one. The same thing in grade two and grade three. Teachers were given boxes for mathematics and the teacher guides and LABs. Remember, in the teacher assistant arm, I said one of the responsibilities of the teacher assistant was to ensure that activities are completed. What was the rationale for the TA intervention in Limpopo? In Limpopo, 91% of learners did not reach the lowest benchmark in reading. That was from the PIRLS report 2016. Secondly, in 2019, the unemployment rate among youth in Limpopo, who were aged between 18 and 25, was 76%. This is the report we got from the Stats SA 2019. The third reason is that teacher assistants were one of the most promising solutions to the dual crisis of youth unemployment and low learning outcomes that arrive in South Africa. So these are the reasons that motivated us to come to Limpopo. How were TAs recruited? It was a very long process, a rigorous and robust process of selection. The first thing that we did is we requested lists of schools from the Department of Education, and we are so thankful that they were so cooperative, from the province to the districts to the circuit. They gave us a list. And then in this instance, because we wanted to work in Capricorn, we prioritized only schools in Capricorn. The number of schools in Capricorn district, Capricorn North and South together, is 572, and we only wanted 120. And as such, we developed a selection criteria that we used to select schools that were eligible for our intervention. One of the criterion is that we wanted schools that were doing Sepedi, which is the official language in South Africa and in Limpopo. Sepedi as a language of learning and teaching, and we didn't want to work in multi-grade classes. Those were some of the criteria. And then the selection was not done by us, but it was administered by SALDRU, South African Labour Development Research Unit, headed by Professor Kelly Eddington. We gave her the list of those schools that applied, and then she checked the ones that were qualifying and randomly assigned them to the different arms. Number two, we sourced candidates. How did we do this? We distributed flyers all over Capricorn North and South to, we distributed them to public institutions like clinics, hospitals, schools, shops. And another thing that we did is we sent the message on social media platforms like Facebook, WhatsApp, SMSs, and by word of mouth. And then from this process, we received about 2,400 applications. Then the third step was we had to select the ones that were qualifying for Funda Wande program. The criteria was we wanted someone with a matric or somebody with a matric plus. And they had to be between 18 and 28. Age was another criterion. And then from the applications, those 2,400, those who qualified, those who were aged between 18 and 28 with matric or with matric plus a degree, were 1,200. And then we invited them to our hubs. We organized six hubs, three in Capricorn North, three in Capricorn South, and then they took the online assessments. four online assessments: numerical reasoning, verbal reasoning, work values, and personal attributes. So each assessment took about 40 minutes. They were given tablets, smartphones, and laptops, as well as data. And they were invigilated during the assessment. And out of the 1,200 that took the assessment, only 256 performed well during the online assessments. And then the fourth step that we took to select the number that we targeted, which was 145, was to bring them together to a central place, a boot camp, where there were mathematics experts from Funda Wande, literacy experts. They gave learners topics and they discussed and did practical activities while they were selecting them. And then finally, we got to the list of 145. The roles and responsibilities of TAs, to name but a few: administration, handling of learning and teaching support materials, help teachers to identify and support struggling learners, do remedial exercises with small group of learners, play math and language games, and also conduct physical education activities, both inside and outside with the children. Why was it necessary to train teachers and teacher assistants? It was important for us because teachers needed to understand the program of Funda Wande as a whole. What did Funda Wande program entail? How were they expected to utilize the materials in the classrooms? How were teachers and teacher assistants expected to work together? So that is why we had to call them to a training. So the two pictures that you see are pictures of teacher training done by experts. And then we conducted four trainings in the year. Training for term one for 4 days, term two training 4 days, term three training 4 days. So in the 4 days, 2 days we're focusing on mathematics, 2 days for literacy or home language. The same thing happened to the teacher assistants. They attended training for 4 days in each term, 2 days maths, 2 days literacy. And then in term one of the intervention, we welcomed them all into the Funda Wande program and gave an overview and background of our intervention. And then for the teacher assistants, we explained the standard operating procedures, where we took them through Funda Wande policies and protocols and systems. And then number three, classroom readiness. Because teacher assistants are not qualified teachers, it was important for us to just outline to them how they should carry themselves when they are in the schools, how they should interact with young kids. Number four, in each term, we unpacked the contents, the mathematics contents for term one, mathematics contents for term two, mathematics contents for term three. The same thing applies to literacy. And then lastly, we reminded them about the partnership agreement that they've signed. It was an agreement between the TA and the teacher. And it helped us to resolve many issues where there were conflicts. Let's look at the evaluation. Remember, the randomization was done by Professor Kelly Eddington from SANDRU. So even the evaluation, the same unit conducted the baseline, midline, and endline. So I'll be talking through the literacy assessment that learners took. For baseline, midline, and endline, we used the EGRA tool, which is the early grade reading assessment, and then learners were assessed on letter sound, syllables, oral reading fluency 1, reading comprehension 1 and 2, oral fluency 2, and words and complex consonants. So here you can already see that the performance of learners between the coaching arm, LTSM represent materials. They were receiving materials plus coachings. So the coaching learners were struggling with oral reading comprehension 1 and 2, whereas the learners in the TAM performed well in all the subtasks. And then when we compared learners in the three arms, the percentage of grade one learners reading a grade one benchmark during the midline, in the control, 42%, the materials or the coaching arm is 48%, the TAM is 59%. And then let's look at the percentage of learners, grade 2 learners meeting grade 2 benchmark in 2022. Learners who did not reach grade 2 benchmark in 2022 from the control arm, 82%, LTSM 70%, TAM 66%. So the numbers are decreasing depending on the intervention. And then this, the last columns represent learners who were in grade 2, but they were able to reach grade 3 benchmarks. So in the control is 6%, 12% in LTSM, 16% in the TAM. And then we also used ECMA for mathematics, early grade mathematics assessment. And then these were the subtasks that learners were assessed on. And then there were gains in higher order skills, such as word sums. So let's look at how learners performed in terms of sums. Word sums, during the baseline assessment, learners who were able to complete subtraction sums correct per minute were 0.9 in the control, 1.1 in the coaching arm, and 1.6 in the TAM. And then during midline in 2022, 3.0, 3.9, and 4.5 in the TAM. So we can see that the TAM performed much, much higher than the coaching arm, and the coaching arm performed better than the control arm. Let's look at the addition sums per minute. Learners who were able to complete addition sums correct per minute during baseline, 2.0%, 1.9% coaching arm, and then TAM 2.4%. Let's look at the midline results, 3.9 in the control, 5.1, and 5.2. So we can see that the LTSM, which is the coaching arm, is also performing much better. It's not very different from the TAM. Okay, the grade 3, the end line assessment, they were still, grade 3 learners were assessed on the same subtasks. And then let's look at the performance of learners in grade 2 and grade 3. Let's start with grade 3. And in the control arm, 21% of learners could not read a word during the end line, 10% in the coaching arm, 13% in the TAM. And then on the far right, this is the learners who were able to reach grade 3 benchmark last year while they were in grade 3, 15% in the control, 25% in the coaching arm, and 32% in the TAM. We want to share with you the highlights and challenges that we experienced as an organization. Number one highlight is that TAs can be highly effective in improving foundational literacy, numeracy, and numeracy outcomes when rigorous recruitment and selection is in place. Majority of TAs were motivated to become teachers while they were in the program of Funda Wande. Retention of teachers, strong school community engagement, and lastly, a sense of ownership in the communities. The challenges, we recruited the first cohort of TAs in 2020 during COVID. So COVID itself was a challenge for us. Connectivity issues in the hubs, internet was unstable in other areas. Churning, some of the TAs left because they had to go and further their studies. Others got jobs. Remember, we had TAs who had matric plus other qualifications. So they got offers somewhere. And then about 20% of the TAs fell pregnant because they were in their late 20s and starting their families. And then relationship issues between teachers and TAs, this was resolved through the partnership agreement. Funding of the TA program was another challenge, and non-compliance of policies and procedures. The lessons learned is that if a government wants to implement a TA program, they need to put four things in place: high quality materials, intensive training of teachers and teacher assistants, and ongoing monitoring and support. TA program can serve as a solution to the dual crisis of youth unemployment and low learning outcomes. South African government can extend the Funda Wande TA intervention program through basic education employment initiative. And lastly, the vision of helping children to read for meaning and calculate with confidence can only be realized if Funda Wande can work closely with other like-minded organizations. And then how do we support the Limpopo province with rollout? We've been sharing our reports, our best practices or good practices as they were implementing the TA program that were funded by government. Number two, we have also provided guidance on how government can implement this program across the whole province. And our resources are freely accessible on the website. Everybody is welcome to download and use all the resources that we have developed the way they want, as long as they acknowledge that it's from Funda Wande. And then we are planning to support stakeholders when they plan to conduct training of teachers and teacher assistants if funding is available. So in a nutshell, this is what I wanted to share with you regarding our TA intervention program. Thanks.